morning. We have a general topic, satellite communication. So, first question is, what is satellite? In astronomical terms, a satellite is a celestial body that orbits around a planet, any planet. It is a celestial body. That is a definition according to astronomical terms. In terms of aerospace term, however, a satellite is a space vehicle launched by humans and orbits Earth or another celestial body. The first active satellite is Sputnik 1, launched by Russia in 1957, and Aryabhata is the first Indian artificial satellite, as you know. So this is the image of Aryabhata and this is the image of Sputnik 1. The laws governing the motion of satellite or any celestial body is Kepler's laws of planetary motion. Kepler's first law says that the planets moves in ellipse with the sun at one of its foci. This law is called the law of areas, the law of orbits. The law states that the planets move in ellipse with the sun at one of its foci. As you know, an ellipse have a major axis and two foci. This is first focus and this is second focus. Sun will be one of its foci, one of the two foci. Planets moves around the sun in an elliptical orbit. This is major axis and this is minor axis. Half of the major axis is called a semi-major axis. Second law, Kepler says that the line joining planet to the sun sweeps out equal areas in equal intervals of time. For example, this is the position of the planet and this is the position of the sun, which is one of its foci. So the line joining planet and sun is this line. This line sweeps an area delta A during a time interval delta T. In some other position, look at this point, the line joining planet and the sun is this line. And this line also sweeps the same area in the same time interval delta T. Or in other words, these two areas are equal. So that is second law of Kepler. Third law, in one word, we can say that the square of time of revolution of a planet divided by the cube of its mean distance from sun gives a number that is same for all planets. In other words, the square of the time period is directly proportional to the cube of the semi-major axis. So that quantity alpha is called the semi-major axis. And A is a constant and P is the mean solar Earth days, that is the time period of Earth. So the ratio TS to T, that is the one sidereal day to the time of one revolution of Earth, is called P. And when we solve that constant, we'll get 0.9972. Now we are talking about the satellite orbits. Satellite orbits can be classified in many ways. The path through which a satellite revolves around a planet is called actually satellite orbit. If a satellite is orbiting in the same direction as the Earth rotation and with the same velocity, with the angular velocity greater than that of Earth, the orbit is called a prograde orbit. We have another orbit called a retrograde orbit. That is, if the satellite is orbiting in opposite direction or in same direction with an angular velocity less than that of Earth, the orbit is called a retrograde. So with the speed of angular velocity, we can classify Earth orbits or orbits, satellite orbits into two, that is prograde and retrograde. Prograde orbits are orbits with a planet is revolving or satellite is revolving with angular velocity greater than that of Earth, and retrograde orbit with an angular velocity less than that of Earth. Then another classification, Earth satellite elevation categories. There are three elevation categories: low Earth orbit LEO, and medium Earth orbit MEO, and geosynchronous Earth orbit GEO. Low Earth orbit means approximately 480 miles above the Earth surface. They are close to the Earth surface. pass path loss between Earth station and the space station is much lower. That means the communication length is very smaller, therefore path loss is very small. And this require lower transmit power and a smaller antenna, because the satellites are very close to the surface of Earth, so they require minimum transmission antennas, smaller antennas. Then second one is medium Earth orbit. They orbit between 6,000 miles and 12,000 miles above the Earth surface. And the geosynchronous orbits, they are 22,000, approximately 22, above 22,000 miles, and they are most commercial communication satellites. They are used for commercial and weather predictions, etc. Then satellite orbital patterns, according to the way in which a satellite revolves around Earth, the orbits can be classified into three: inclined orbit, equatorial orbit, and polar orbit. This is polar orbits. They revolve from pole to pole, north pole to south pole, and equatorial orbit revolves around the equatorial plane of the Earth, and inclined orbit, they orbit at an angle and an angle of inclination with the equatorial plane of the Earth. Inclined orbits are all orbits except those travel above or directly over the north-south poles. The angle of inclination is the angle between Earth equatorial plane and the orbital plane of the satellite. So now we have a satellite which is recently launched from India, that is Chandrayaan 2. So why Moon? First point is the origin and evolution of Moon and solar system. By collecting the data from Moon, we are actually formulating a theory that give light on the origin and evolution of Moon and solar system. Second one is to show India's potential to launch such a vehicle and to send a rover to Moon. And the third point is 1 million tons of helium on the Moon surface. As we know, helium is believed to be the fuel of future. In the future, helium will be the fuel. Helium will replace diesel and petrol or all other fuels at present in use. So actually we are going to study the amount of heliums and the extraction of helium from Moon. And the final point is the outpost for further planetary exploration. Moon will be the outpost, will be an outpost for the further or future planetary explorations. What makes Chandrayaan 2 special compared to all other mission to Moon? Why Chandrayaan 2 is special? Chandrayaan 2 is the first space mission to conduct a soft landing on the Moon's south polar region. No other vehicles reached the Moon's south polar region. So Chandrayaan 2 is the first space mission to Moon's south polar region in a soft landing mode. And the first Indian expedition to attempt a soft landing on lunar surface with the homegrown technology. The technology used in Chandrayaan 2 is homegrown. First Indian mission to explore the lunar terrain with the homegrown technology. And the fourth country even to soft land on lunar surface. That is why Chandrayaan 2 is special. Objectives of this mission includes demonstrate the ability to soft land on the lunar surface and operate a robotic rover on the surface. The rover is called Pragyan. Lunar topography, mineralogy, and elemental abundance are the main objectives of Chandrayaan 2 mission. Why explore lunar south pole? Why won't we choose north pole? Why we select south pole? The answer is, in the south pole there are a large area that are under shadow. The shadow regions, there is a large possibility of finding the presence of water. So therefore we are landing, soft landing on the south pole rather than North Pole. And South Pole has a lot of craters that are cold traps and contains a fossil record of the early solar system. So these are the reason why we are landing on lunar south pole. Okay, so here is a video that shows the Chandrayaan launching from 22 July to 2:43 PM from Sriharikota, Andhra Pradesh. So here is a video that shows the launching of Mark 3, GSLV Mark 3 carrying Chandrayaan 2. So this is the launch, and GSLV carries Chandrayaan 2 to the space. Detachment of two fuel tanks, and in the space the satellite detaches from the orbiter. This is a rocket. This is the orbiter, and here the orbiter separates. This is the orbiter, satellite. So it revolves around Earth in this manner. This is the path of the orbiter, satellite. And after a few days, it will be shifted to Moon's orbital path. This is the orbital path of Earth. So there is a shift from Earth path to Moon's orbital path. Transfer of orbit, Earth to Moon. So there is a transfer from Earth to Moon. So this is Moon, there is a transfer. And it revolves around the Moon. This is the satellite. This revolves around Moon in a specified way. Thereafter, the Vikram separates. Vikram is the satellite. Vikram and orbiter. Vikram is the lander which lands on the Moon surface. So Vikram scans the Moon surface to find a position to soft land. This is the orbiter. Orbiter scans image, scans the image from the Moon surface, and Vikram scans the surface for soft landing. The landing site, it scans the landing site, and finally Vikram lands on the Moon's surface. It is a soft land, and the rover comes out, and when the Vikram lands on the Moon's surface, it immediately sends information to Earth, the images and all other things from Moon's to Earth. It starts communicating with the Earth. That is on the September 6th of 2019. This is just an animated video by ISRO. So the things shown in this video are yet to happen next 2 months. 14 days, the lifespan of the rover and the lander are 14 days, and the lifespan of the orbiter is 1 year. So the Chandrayaan orbiter will orbit Moon for 1 year, but the rover and the Vikram, that is the lander, only have a 14 days of lifespan. So from September 16 to 14 days, it will collect the informations and send it to Earth.